Hello, in this video, I'll be showing you what you need to do if you are an existing student or if you have paid for any course in 321study.com. Okay, always know that you can always talk to us here and on the live support and we'll respond to you immediately. If you are connecting to our website with your mobile device, you will also see a button here with our phone number on it. You can call directly from your mobile device and we will respond to you. Okay, if you are an existing student, all you need to do is to go to the account page right over here. You've clicked it. As soon as you click the account page, you'll see an option to put in your email, your email address or your username and your password. The email address you need to put in here is the email address you use when you are paying and the password you created when you were trying to pay for the course. Okay, when you are done with that, you need to click the login button to access the course. Now, do not forget, if you forget your password, you can also click lost your password and you will be redirected to a page where you need to put in your email address. And if your email address is existing in our platform as a student, you have an option to create new password. So if you are a student, all you need to do is put in your email address, which is this, and your password. And you click login. As soon as you click login, you will land at this page where you will see your orders, downloads, your address. You can manage your login information from here. But if you want to start studying, all you need to do is click my courses. If you are enrolled as a membership, all you need to do is click my membership. But for now, I'm enrolled in just one course, so I need to click my course. As soon as you click my course, all the courses you are currently enrolled in will appear here. Okay, so far I'm only enrolled in strategic financial management and I want to proceed to studying. All I need to do is click strategic financial management. While you are in strategic financial management, you will see on the left hand side your progress bar, which shows you the percentage of the course you have covered. So far, I've only covered 3.7% of the course. Okay, when you scroll down, you will see all the resources available to you that you can start working on. So for this course, we have overview of strategic financial management. You have your download SFM pocket note. So if you click this download SFM pocket note, it will show you a button where you need to click download and the pocket note for SFM will be made available to you. And if you want to take any lesson, all you need to do is to click on the lesson you want to take. Assuming I want to take lesson 2 on cost of capital, all I need to do is click lesson 2, cost of capital. As soon as you click lesson 2, cost of capital, it will bring you to the video of the lesson. Okay, all you need to do is to click this play button. And the video will start playing for you. Cost of capital, lesson 2.
Cost of capital. We'll be looking at the definitions. Now we want to move into the calculations. Before we go into the calculations, let's look at how we calculate work. Then we'll look at the components of those work calculations. I said for you to calculate work, you need to get cost of everything. Remember, I said work is the average.
So, I just pause this video. You can continue to the end. Okay, now I need to show one other key feature. On our platform, assuming you are in an area and where the internet connection is not that strong, all you need to do is click this gear wheel here, and it will open up to the video quality. Currently, it is on auto, and it will always be on auto. Okay, but if you can decide to downgrade it to the lowest quality. Now, I need to remind us that no matter the quality you have chosen, you will see the video clearly. And you will also get to hear the audio clearly. If you are streaming with the lowest quality, it also saves you data, okay? But ordinarily, the video will load on auto, okay? Now, it's also very important that you do not press any of these while the video is playing. Ensure that you are not moving it forward, you are not moving it back. If it's not very necessary, allow the video to play seamlessly. Do not press any of these, because if you press any button, it will start loading all over again, which you don't want to experience. So as soon as it loads the first time, allow it to play, unless it's very, very necessary that you press anything here on the control bar. Now, it is also very important that when you are done with any part, any lesson, you click mark as complete. Very important, so that you will know where you've stopped. Okay? Assuming you've marked this lesson complete, when next you log in, you'll be clear that you'll be sure that you have completed that lesson. Now, if you've marked a lesson complete, okay? Now, you see, it's showing here that I've completed this lesson. Now, that you've marked a lesson complete does not mean it will remain completed. You can always go back to that lesson and unmark it as complete. Okay? So, for marking this lesson complete, my progress has improved from 3.7% to 5.6%. So, by the time you complete this course, your progress would have been 100%. And also, it's important that you do not give anybody your login details, because if someone has your login detail, the person might start marking some lessons completed, and those lessons are areas where you have not actually covered. Okay, within the course resources, you will also have your assignment, which will appear on the left hand side when you enroll. If you click the assignment, you will be able to either write the assignment on the face of the website and click upload, or solve the assignment somewhere else and upload the document. Or if the assignment is a task type of assignment, it will also tell you what to do as per the task. Okay, now I want to show you the course forum. If you are in this video area, you won't be able to access the course forum. But if you want to do that, you need to go back to strategic financial management. So while you're on strategic financial management, you can go all the way down to this point where you see the course forum. Okay, I can decide to enter the forum by clicking strategic financial management forum. As soon as you click strategic financial management forum, it will take you directly to the forum where you can easily create a topic by putting in the name of the topic you want to create. And you ask your question here. After which you can submit. Now, if you submit a topic, all you need to do is come back to the course forum later on to see if your course instructor or your fellow student have replied you. Okay, you will always see any question, any topic you created, and the replies underneath. Okay, this brings us to the end of this video. If you have further questions about 3-2-1 study, please don't hesitate to go to the homepage and click on the live support chat. You can also call us directly if you are accessing the website from your mobile device. Bye.